Ok, very well. So, estamos en la sesión de la tarde de Basic y hoy vamos a aprender vocabulario nuevo para hablar del clima, vocabulary for the weather, y vamos a practicar nuestro listening con respecto a hablar del clima. El objeto es que ustedes puedan dar la temperatura. Ese es el objeto, hablar de la temperatura. No tanto del clima, sino de la temperatura y saber decir son 5 degrees Celsius, 20 degrees Celsius o grados Fahrenheit. Vamos a aprender eso, ¿ok? Ok, very good. So, let's get to work on the vocabulary first. La primera, vamos a numerarlo mejor para que se les haga más fácil. Ok, good. So, la primera pregunta es, aquí vamos a usar la contracción mejor. What's the temperature like today? Vamos a proyectárselos ahorita, ¿ok? A mí a veces se me olvida proyectarlo. Just remind me, okay? Solo me recuerdan. All right. So here we have number one. What's the temperature like today? What's the temperature like today? Number two, temperature. 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 Como toda palabra, tenemos la schwa que desaparece y aquí la letra E. Desaparece. Entonces no vamos a decir temperature. Vamos a decir temperature. Can you guys say that?
Temperature.
For me? Temperature.
Temperature. Temperature.
That's correct. Temperature. Temperature. ¿Qué pasaba con las palabras que tenían T-U? ¿Qué pasa con ese sonido? ¿Qué sonido se hace? Que es prácticamente el... ahí se va el puntero, perdón. Ok, entonces aquí es, este son, de la T con la U, se van a pronunciar de esta manera. Ch, ch, ch. Temperature. 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 Ok. Temperature. Y aquí... vamos a tener una schwa. ¿Se recuerdan la schwa? Aquí va a ser una schwa. No la vamos a leer como temperature. Temperature. Temperature.
Temperature.
Temperature.
Temperature.
Sí, la que se estaría desapareciendo sería esta. Temperature. Temperature. Very good. Ahora la pregunta dice, what's the temperature like today? Can you guys say it? What's the temperature?
What's the temperature like today?
Very good. What's the temperature like today? A ver, inténtelo, Marcos. Inténtelo, Marcos. What's the temperature like today?
What's the temperature like today?
Good. Diga temperature.
Temperature.
Thank you. Okay, Jocelyn, please.
What's the temperature like today?
Thank you very much. Ok, good. Pasemos a la siguiente palabra. Es thermometer. Thermometer. Ther. Primer sílaba. Ma. Therma. We got a schwa. Hay una schwa ahí. Perdón el puntero este. Ok. Aquí sería thermometer. 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 Otro schwa aquí. Thermometer. Can you say it? ¿Pueden decirlo? Thermometer.
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 Thermometer. Very good. Thermometer. Good. Thermometer es el instrumento que usamos para medir la temperatura. Next, Celsius. Celsius. Here, the U is a schwa. Celsius. Can you guys say it? Celsius.
Celsius.
Celsius. Very good. Celsius es una medida que se usa grados Celsius para medir la temperatura. Next, we have Fahrenheit. 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 Fahrenheit, Fahrenheit. Aquí va a ser E, Fahrenheit. height. Aquí va a haber un diptongo, va a existir un diptongo. Ahí, height. Height, Fahrenheit. Díganlo.
Fahrenheit.
Very good.
Fahrenheit.
Good. Fahrenheit. Next, este simbolito les va a aparecer, por ejemplo, si ustedes me preguntan, what's the weather like in Guatemala? What's the weather? Or what's the temperature? I'm sorry, what's the temperature? Today is 28 degrees. Se lee este círculo. Celsius. You understand? 28 degrees Celsius. ¿Cómo se va a leer eso?
28 Celsius.
28 degrees, el símbolo este, Celsius. Repeat after me. 28 degrees.
Degrees.
Celsius.
Celsius.
Good. It's, porque están diciendo son, it's 28 degrees Celsius. It's 28 degrees Celsius.
It's 28 degrees Celsius.
Thank you. So let me ask Lauren. Lauren, le pregunto y me contesta. What's the temperature like today?
It's 28 Celsius.
Degrees. Tienes que leer el simbolito este, el círculo.
The 28 degrees.
Degrees. Exacto, aquí mira. Este, si miras este símbolo, este círculo encima del número, tienes que leerlo como degrees.
Ok, 28 degrees Celsius.
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 That's great. Okay. Muy bien. Ahora, existe también la medida en Guatemala. Usamos el sistema este del... ¿Cuál es que usamos? El sistema métrico. No, sí, el métrico es, ¿verdad? Celsius. Entonces usamos los Celsius, los grados Celsius. Pero en Estados Unidos se utiliza mucho el Fahrenheit. Fahrenheit, que está acá. Es otra medida de la temperatura, pero si otra cambio esto, estos Celsius, los paso a Fahrenheit. Entonces en Fahrenheit tendríamos hoy 82 degrees Fahrenheit. ¿Ok? Lo mismo aquí, si hago la conversión de 28 Celsius, lo cambio al sistema este de Fahrenheit, tendríamos, today is 82 degrees Fahrenheit. ¿Ok? Primero leo el número, lo leo normal, ¿va? Leo el número, 82. ¿Ok? Leo el número normal, 82. Luego leo el círculo, degrees. Y de último... El sistema Fahrenheit. Okay.
Fahrenheit.
Repeat after me. It's
82
degrees
Fahrenheit.
Fahrenheit.
That's correct. It's 82 degrees Fahrenheit. Todos juntos. It's 82 degrees Fahrenheit.
It's the 82 degrees Fahrenheit.
That is correct. Very good. Are we good with that?
Yes.
All right, good. Muy bien. All right, let's continue. Continuamos, pues. Let's continue. Okay, good. Muy bien. Pero hay noches o hay días donde el clima es muy frío. It's too cold. ¿Ok? Entonces, cuando es así muy frío, tenemos que usar el menos. Cuando hay nieve, cuando es muy helado, usamos el menos, ¿ok? Este símbolo, el menos en inglés se dice minus. Minus. ¿Cómo se dice?
Minus.
Minus.
Y aquí este es otro schwa. Minus.
Minus.
Minus. ¿Ok? Y aquí este es un diptongo. Ahí. My. Ness. Vamos a leerlo así. My
nest.
Oh my God, qué fea esa schwa. Esa es la schwa más fea que he visto en mi vida. Minus. Okay, good. Vamos a volver a hacer ese schwa. Minus. Like this. Minus. Alarán, se corre esta cosa a veces. Sorry for that. Okay. Minus. Are we good? Minus. ¿Estamos ahí?
Minus.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Very good. Okay, very good. So, Timas, thank you for joining us. Having problems with the audio there, make sure to set it up, okay? Very good. Okay, estamos ahí, minus. Entonces, cuando cuando hay mucho frío, está helado, vamos a utilizar el minus y lo vamos a poner así. Por ejemplo, digamos, ¿cómo está el clima? ¿Cómo se decía Noruega?
Norway.
Thank you. Norway. Very good. So what's the weather? What's the temperature in Norway? What's the temperature in Norway? Okay. Bueno, en Norway tenemos esto. Miren pues, en Norway, the temperature is this. Esta es la temperatura. In Norway, como es tan frío, hoy amaneció -3 degrees Celsius. Miren eso. Está bajo cero, below zero. Debajo, en cero, comienza a formarse la nieve. El agua se solidifica y se vuelve hielo, nieve, lo que conocemos, ¿verdad? Esto traducido a grados Fahrenheit, ¿verdad? Y en grados Fahrenheit sería 38. En grados Fahrenheit, esto sería traducido a 38. ¿Cómo se lee el círculo? Degrees Fahrenheit. ¿Ok?
Ok.
Got it? Okay, okay. Great. So, ¿qué quiere decir eso? En Norway está, hay frío. Está bien helado ahorita. It's cold. En Guatemala, it's hot. ¿Ok? Les pregunto, what's the temperature like in Norway? What's the temperature like in Norway? What's the temperature like in Norway? Let's see. Jason.
These are Celsius.
Okay, otra vez. Minus.
Minus.
Three. Degrees.
Degrees, okay. Degrees.
Celsius.
Celsius.
Very good. Te vuelvo a preguntar, what's the temperature like in Norway?
Okay, it's minus.
Minus?
Minus. It's minus 3 degrees Celsius.
Celsius.
Celsius. Celsius.
That's correct. Thank you. What's the weather like in Norway, Loren?
Degrees.
What's the weather like in Norway, Loren?
It's minus 3 degrees Celsius.
Very good. What's the weather like in Norway? Let's see. Marcos. It's
-3 degrees
Celsius.
Celsius.
Good, very good. Ahora vamos a decirlo en Fahrenheit. 38 degrees Fahrenheit. Everybody with me. 38 degrees Fahrenheit.
Fahrenheit.
Fahrenheit. Acuérdense de la
Fahrenheit.
Schwa. That's correct.
Fahrenheit.
Very good. So, ahora me van a dar la respuesta en Fahrenheit. What's the weather like in Norway? Jocelyn.
It's 38 degrees Fahrenheit.
Thank you very much. What's the weather like in Norway? Lauren?
38 degrees Fahrenheit.
That's correct. Very good. Bueno, entonces repasemos. Este vocabulario lo necesitamos hoy. We need it today. Number one, what's the temperature like today?
What's the temperature like today?
Okay, again, what's the temperature like today?
What's the temperature like today? What's
good. Number two, temperature.
Temperature.
Three, thermometer.
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 Thermometer. Four, Celsius.
Celsius.
Okay, great. Five, Fahrenheit.
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 Six, degrees.
Degrees.
Minus.
Minus.
Good. Ahora leamos, let's read. So we're going to say 28 degrees Celsius.
28 degrees Celsius.
Okay. 82 degrees Fahrenheit.
82 degrees Fahrenheit.
Good. Minus 3 degrees Fahrenheit.
Minus 3 degrees Fahrenheit.
38 degrees Fahrenheit.
Height.
38 degrees Fahrenheit.
Good. Very good. Ahora vámonos a la página, page 142, please. Page 142. Okay, let's go to page 142. De su libro, open up your book to page 142. Okay? Got it?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, great. Vamos a completar las actividades del libro. El último vocabulario que tenemos de esta unidad, okay? So it's activity 4B, the weather and the seasons. The weather and the seasons. El clima y las temporadas.
Okay.
Very good. The weather and the seasons. Okay. So let's go to that vocabulary section and let's complete that together. Okay, good. Hello, Mr. Dimas. Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
All right. Thank you for joining us today. How are you?
Kenya is here too.
Oh, hi, Kenya. Thank you for joining us.
Hi, Kenya.
Hi.
Great to have you. Great to have you. Qué bueno. Estamos en la página 142. Page 142.
Sí, ya la tenemos en el libro.
Excellent. Thank you. Thank you for joining us to our class. We really appreciate it. Okay? Okay. Good. Okay, so now let's go to your book and let me share the screen. Vamos a compartir la pantalla si lo hacemos juntos, okay? Let's share it. Okay, good. Y vamos a ir a 4B, the weather and the seasons. The weather and the seasons. Okay. Okay, great. Entonces, aquí ya sabemos leer, ¿verdad? Vamos a leerlos juntos. Let's read them together. The first one is la temperatura. What's the temperature like in Barcelona? It's 22 degrees. What's the temperature like in St. Petersburg? It's minus 11 degrees. What's the weather like in Shanghai? It's 14 degrees. What's the weather like in Mumbai? It's 36 degrees. What's the weather like in San Francisco? It's 12 degrees. What's the weather like in Liverpool? It's 10 degrees. What's the weather like in Stockholm? It's 1 degree. Okay, good. So, dice aquí, look at the pictures and complete the sentences with the cities, listen and check. Okay, tenemos que completar. Dice, one, it's raining or rainy in, y ponemos aquí el lugar. Two, it's snowing and snowy in, and we put the place. Tienen que ustedes subrayar. It's hot in, y ponen el lugar, okay? All right. Okay. So here we go. Voy a compartir el audio aquí. Just a sec.
One, it's raining in Liverpool.
¿Cómo? ¿Lo logran escuchar? Can you hear it?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, repito de nuevo. Here we go.
One, it's raining in Liverpool.
All right. What did he say? It's rainy or it's raining?
It's raining.
Raining.
Raining where? In what place? In qué lugar?
Liverpool.
Liverpool. So number one is Liverpool. Okay? Number one.
It's rainy in Liverpool. Two.
It's snowing in Stockholm.
It's snowing in where? Stockholm. So number two.
It's snowy in Stockholm.
It's snowy in Stockholm.
Three. It's hot in Mumbai.
Where is it hot?
Barcelona.
Mumbai.
Mumbai. So this is three.
Four.
It's warm in Barcelona.
It's warm where?
Barcelona.
Barcelona. Four.
Five. It's very cold in St. Petersburg.
It's very cold in?
St. Petersburg.
St. Petersburg, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, so that's number five. Number five, okay.
Six.
It's wet in Liverpool.
It's wet. Seven. It's wet in Liverpool. So this one is also six.
Okay.
It's sunny in Barcelona.
Sunny where?
Barcelona.
Barcelona with a schwa. Seven.
Eight.
It's foggy in San Francisco.
It's foggy in San Francisco. Eight goes here.
Nine. It's windy in Shanghai.
Where is it windy?
In the Shanghai.
Shanghai.
In Shanghai.
Eight. Ten.
It's cloudy in Mumbai.
Where is it cloudy?
Mumbai.
Mumbai. You got it.
11. It's icy in St. Petersburg.
It's icy in where?
St. Petersburg.
St. Petersburg.
St. Petersburg.
12.
It's cold in Stockholm.
It's cold where?
Stockholm.
Stockholm. Very good. All right, very good. That's how it's done. Así se hace. That's how it's done. Okay, great. So let's close this part. Mm-hmm. And now let's go to the book part again. Let's go to the listening part. Let's return to the listening part. Okay.
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 Let's return back to the page where we were, which is page 33. Let's go back to page 33. Page 33.
Okay.
Page 33. Okay. Back to page 33. We're doing this listening part right now. Okay. So what are we going to do? Activity number six. Actividad seis.
Okay.
Dice, watch or listen again. Choose the correct options to complete the sentences. Escoja la opción correcta para completar. All right?
Okay.
Okay, good.
All right.
So it says, number one, ahí lo pueden ver ustedes en su texto, right? Si no se ve bien aquí. Okay, good. Number one. A ver, pues. Marina says it's 17 degrees minus 7 degrees or 18 degrees. Tienen tres opciones. You have to choose the correct one. Two. She goes to her sister's house after breakfast in the afternoon or in the evening. Tienen que escuchar por esa información. Three. Sam says it's sometimes, usually, always hot and sunny in Egypt. So, again, you have to listen for the adverb. ¿Cuál es el adverbio correcto? Four, his advice is to wear a hat, wear boots, carry an umbrella in hot weather. Tienen que buscar qué información es. Listen for the information. Five, Jenny says the weather forecast is good for Saturday, Monday, or Tuesday. Eso de weather forecast lo vamos a agregar al vocabulario. Ese es, forecast es el pronóstico del clima. Eso lo vamos a agregar también, weather forecast. Okay? And number six, she likes, doesn't like, or hates living in Newfoundland. Newfoundland es una provincia del Canadá. So, escuchen, is likes, doesn't like, or hates living, which is correct. Okay, here we go. Vamos a ver. ¿Entendieron las instrucciones? ¿Cuáles son las instrucciones del ejercicio, Jocelyn? ¿Qué tiene que hacer usted?
Subrayar la opción correcta.
Ok. Sí, exacto. Pero tiene que escuchar por la información correcta. You have to listen for the correct information, ok?
Ok.
All right. Very good.
Here's Marina, our receptionist at Learning Curve in the UK. She's on holiday in Russia with her family. Hi, Marina. What's the temperature in St. Petersburg at the moment?
Hi, Penny. My thermometer says 18 degrees in Fahrenheit and minus 7 in Celsius. I love it. Winter is here.
Wow. So what do you usually do in winter?
I sleep early and wake up early because it's dark here in winter. I walk in the snow after breakfast every day and cook for my family in the afternoon. In the evening, we have dinner at my sister's house.
Well,
I wear this hat every day. It's very warm.
Lovely.
Thanks. See you after my holiday.
Now we have someone on video.
Okay, good. Repito lo de Marina. I'm going to repeat it again. All right. ¿Quién cachó? Did you catch it? ¿Todavía no? Yes. Okay, I'll repeat it again.
Here's Marina, our receptionist at Learning Curve in the UK.
I'm sorry, ¿sí lo escuchan, verdad?
Yes.
Okay.
Here's Marina, our receptionist at Learning Curve in the UK. She's on holiday in Russia with her family. Hi, Marina. What's the temperature in St. Petersburg at the moment?
Hi, Penny. My thermometer says 18 degrees in Fahrenheit and minus 7 in Celsius.
Okay, she said it. Ya lo dijo. What's the answer?
Minus 18 degrees.
Okay, con confianza, Lauren. ¿Cuál es la respuesta? What's the answer?
Minus 7 degrees Celsius.
Correct. Very good. Solo que me pronuncia esto como minus. Minus.
Minus.
Very good. Thank you. Ahora dice, she goes to her sister's house after breakfast in the afternoon or in the evening. Aquí es time expression.
I love it. Winter is here.
Wow. So what do you usually do in winter?
I sleep early and wake up early because it's dark here in winter. I walk in the snow after breakfast every day and cook for my family in the afternoon. In the evening, we have dinner at my sister's house.
Well.
Okay. Let's see. Who caught it? Did you catch it? Is it after breakfast, in the afternoon, or in the evening? Let's see.
In the evening.
In the evening. Is that Dimas?
Yes, in the evening.
Yes, Dimas, correct. You're right. Good job. Number three. Now let's listen to Sam. Vamos a hablar a Sam. Sam, oír a Sam. Sometimes, usually, or always, hot and sunny in Egypt. Let's see.
I wear this hat every day. It's very warm.
Lovely.
Thanks. See you after my holiday.
Now we have someone on video chat from the other side of the world. What's the weather like in Egypt, Sam?
We don't usually talk about weather in Egypt.
Right. It's always hot and sunny in Cairo.
Usually, but not always. Once in 100 years, there's snow.
Wow.
Okay. He said it. Ya dijo.
Usually.
Correct. Usually. Very good. Next, his advice. Advice es consejo. Esto lo vamos a agregar también a la lista. Advice. His advice is to wear a hat, wear boots, carry an umbrella in hot weather.
And what about this year?
Just hot.
So, what's your advice for tourists in Egypt in the spring or summer?
Wear a hat and drink lots of water.
He said it. Ya lo dijo.
A hat.
Yes. Wear a hat.
Don't worry about snow boots for another 100 years.
Thanks, Sam. This is exciting. Now we have Jenny on video chat from a very foggy place. Jenny, hello there. Where are you?
I'm in Argentina, Newfoundland, and Canada.
But I can't see you.
This is my view.
Ah, there you are. That's a lot of fog.
It's like this 200 days a year, even in the spring and summer.
Wow.
The weather report says Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, fog. On Tuesday, a great day. Fog in the morning and a little sun in the afternoon. It's always like this.
Okay, good. She said it. Ya mencionó. Jenny says the weather forecast is good for what day?
Saturday and Monday.
Tuesday and Monday. Pero solo una opción podemos elegir. We'll, only one.
And Saturday?
Tuesday?
Yes. Who said that? That's Jocelyn, right?
Mm-hmm.
Good job.
Do you like living there?
Sure. I get about 100 days of sun a year, so I'm okay. And it's warm and sunny over in the next town today, so I can have dinner there.
Thanks, Jenny, and enjoy Tuesday.
Bye.
Well, Ethan, I think people enjoy all kinds of weather. Ethan?
Okay, finally, la chica que habló de último. She likes, doesn't like, or hates living in Newfoundland. What is it?
Again, please.
¿Quieren oír ese pedazo? No.
Please.
Okay.
In the afternoon. It's always like this.
But I can't see you.
This is my view.
Ah, oh, there you are. That's a lot of fog.
Okay, great. Les va, vamos a hacer algo. Les pongo el video, mejor el clip. Okay. Y la ven ahí a hablar. Okay. Let's do the clip. Es la última persona.
Our receptionist at Learning Curve in the UK. She's on holiday in Russia with her family. Hi, Marina. What's the temperature in St. Petersburg at the moment?
Hi, Penny. My thermometer says 18 degrees in Fahrenheit and -7 in Celsius. I love it. Winter is here.
Wow. So what do you usually do in winter?
I sleep early and wake up early because it's dark here in winter. I walk in the snow after breakfast every day and cook for my family in the afternoon. In the evening, we have dinner at my sister's house.
Well,
I wear this hat every day. It's very warm.
Lovely.
Thanks. See you after my holiday.
Now we have someone on video chat from the other side of the world. What's the weather like in Egypt, Sam?
We don't usually talk about weather in Egypt.
Right. It's always hot and sunny in Cairo.
Usually, but not always. Once in 100 years, there's snow.
Wow. And what about this year?
Just hot.
So what's your advice for tourists in Egypt in the spring or summer?
Wear a hat and drink lots of water. Don't worry about snow boots for another 100 years.
Thanks, Sam. This is exciting. Now we have Jenny on video chat from a very familiar face. Jenny? Hello there. Where are you?
Okay, good. Esta es la última chica de la última pregunta.
I'm in Argentina, Newfoundland, in Canada.
But I can't see you.
This is my view.
Ah, there you are. That's a lot of fog.
It's like this 200 days a year, even in the spring and summer.
Wow.
The weather report says Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, fog. On Tuesday, a great day. Fog in the morning and a little sun in the afternoon. It's always like this.
Do you like living there?
Sure. I get about 100 days of sun a year, so I'm okay. And it's warm and sunny over in the next town today, so I can have dinner there.
Thanks, Jenny.
Okay. Very good. So, finally, number 6. She likes, doesn't like, hates living in Newfoundland.
She likes.
Yeah, absolutely. Le vieron la cara. She likes it. Y hasta dijo, yes, I like it. She likes the weather. Le gusta el clima. Okay, very good. Estamos ahí. We're there, right? So this one is she likes living in Newfoundland. Okay, are we good with that? ¿Estamos bien ahí?
Yes.
Okay. Very good. Bueno, aquí hay un vocabulario que también vamos a agregar a la lista. Es el que está acá, el number 7, vocabulary number 7, dice aquí. Si lo tienen ahí, dice, in the winter, it's a good idea to wear warm clothes. Okay? In the winter, it's a good idea to wear warm clothes. Listen and repeat. In the winter, it's a good idea to wear warm clothes.
In the winter, it's a good idea to wear warm clothes.
That's correct. Okay, esta frase está muy buena. It's a good idea. Es una buena idea. It's a good idea to wear, de usar, o vestirse con ropa caliente, warm clothes. Okay? Ahora, si fuera verano, ¿cómo lo sería? In the summer, it's a good idea to wear what?
Light clothes.
Yes, light clothes or fresh clothes, right? Okay, so if, let's say, si alguien viene a visitar a Guatemala, un extranjero, digamos, somebody from Norway is visiting Guatemala, ¿qué recomendación le harían? Advice. ¿Qué consejo? Whatever. Advice es un consejo.
In Guatemala, it's a good idea to wear warm clothes, maybe.
Okay. Very good. In Guatemala,
Depends the department.
Depends on the department. Let's say this person is visiting the city.
Okay. Okay, in this season, I will advise to wear fresh clothes.
Fresh clothes. That is correct. So the sentence would be, in Guatemala, it's a good idea to wear fresh clothes. Thanks a lot, Dimas. Great answer. Okay. So there you go. In Guatemala, it's a good idea to wear fresh clothes. Okay. Thanks, Dimas. Ahora, let's see. Lauren, are you there, Lauren?
Yes.
Okay. Let's see si alguien visita un departamento frío. A ver. En un departamento frío, Dimas.
Tecpan.
¿Ah? Tecpan, okay. En Tecpan. A ver, ¿qué le recomendarías, Loren? En Tecpan.
It's a cold.
Mm-hmm.
It's a cool
good idea. Mm-hmm.
To wear.
Mm-hmm. ¿Cómo se dice ropa caliente?
Hot.
Oh, vas a decir warm. Okay.
Okay.
To wear warm clothes.
Clothes.
Okay, good. So you're going to say, in Tecpan, oh, me comí el artículo. It's a good idea to wear warm clothes. Okay, Lauren?
Okay.
Okay, good. Entonces, esta frase sí quiero que sea su takeaway. It's a good idea to wear warm clothes. It's a good idea to wear fresh clothes. Okay, great. Let's move on. Moving on. Siguiendo. Y con esto terminamos la clase de hoy. It's listening builder sentence stress. In English, we usually stress the most important words in the sentence. These stress words are usually nouns, verbs, adjectives, and adverbs. You can usually understand the general idea if you only hear these words. Mount Emi in China gets 27 feet of rain in a year. In the evening, we have dinner at my sister's house. Okay, great. ¿Qué nos dice esto? Que cuando hablamos inglés, las palabras que tienen el acento, que se marcan claramente, siempre son palabras que son sustantivos, nouns, verbs, adjectives, or adverbs. Entonces, ¿qué pasa? Las preposiciones, como en este ejemplo de Mount Emmy en China, a esta preposición no hay acento, no se marca. No diría yo Mount Emmy in China, eso no sucede, sino se va fusionando. Esa palabrita se fusiona o no se pronuncia con tanta, con esa claridad, ¿verdad? Con ese stress que le dicen, ¿verdad? Sentence stress. ¿Ok? Lo que sí se pronuncia fuerte son, o se estresa son los sustantivos, las palabras claves. Mount Emmy in China. In China. Mount Emmy in China gets 27 feet. Esto se estresa, porque es importante. Of rain in a year. La preposición queda fuera, casi que ni se dice. In a, esta se fusiona en la preposición con el artículo. In a. In a year, pero year se dice claramente. En este ejemplo, in the evening, evening es la palabra clave. In the, esto se fusiona. In the, se va fusionando. In the evening. Pruébenlo. In the evening. In the. In the. Estos dos se vuelven una. In the.
In the.
In the. In the evening. We have dinner. Dinner se pronuncia claro. El pronombre no se dice aquí fuerte. At my sister's house. At my. Esto se fusiona. At my sister's house. Es lo que se pronuncia con estrés. Pasemos al ejercicio 8. Exercise 8. Read the listening builder. Read the text and underline the most important words. Vamos a leer el parrafito que está aquí abajo y subrayar las palabras más importantes. Okay.
Okay.
Let's go. Activity 8A. 8A. Okay. Listen, escuchen y van subrayando las palabras claves, the keywords. Okay.
Patagonia is a beautiful part of South America. It's always windy in Patagonia. The wind is sometimes very strong, about 120 kilometers an hour. You can't walk when it's so windy.
Okay, one more time.
Patagonia is a beautiful part of South America. It's always windy in Patagonia. The wind is sometimes very strong, about 120 kilometers an hour. You can't walk when it's so windy.
Okay, very good. So let's underline the key words here. So Patagonia is a beautiful part of South America. It's always windy in Patagonia. It's always windy in Patagonia.
Yeah.
The wind is sometimes very strong. The wind is sometimes very strong. About a hundred se fusiona. Se le da prioridad. About a hundred. And 20 kilometers an hour. 20 kilometers an hour. Hour. You can't walk. You can't walk. When it's so windy. Listen again.
Patagonia is a beautiful part of South America. It's always windy in Patagonia. The wind is sometimes very strong, about 120 kilometers an hour. You can't walk when it's so windy.
Okay. Did you notice that? En fin, las palabras claves como los sustantivos, los adjetivos y los adverbios. Estas palabras llevan la idea principal de la oración, por lo tanto, estas se pronuncian claramente. Por otro lado, las preposiciones, los artículos, estos se fusionan varias veces y no se les da tanto el enfoque en eso, ¿verdad? Tanta claridad, no se pronuncian tan claros como las palabras claves. El objeto es esto, que si usted pone atención a las palabras claves, va a entender la idea principal. That's it. Un ejemplo en la vida real, cuando usted, por ejemplo, yo lo vi muchos años en los call centers, cuando los agentes tomaban llamadas y estaban comenzando con su listening, tenían dificultad, no entendían al cliente, no le entendían. ¿Por qué? Porque ellos esperaban que el cliente les hablara las palabra por palabra. Por ejemplo, I want to activate my service. Y eso nunca pasaba. En la escuela, en el colegio, les enseñan eso. I want to learn, I want to activate my service. Y nadie habla así. Nobody speaks like that. Por eso acá siempre les he estado insistiendo en fusionar palabras. Lo que van a escuchar en la vida real es algo como, I want to activate my service. I want to activate my service. Y si usted no está acostumbrado a eso, entonces se pierde. una forma de poder que coaching verdadero que nosotros les damos a los agentes es simplemente, mire, escuche las palabras claves. Y si yo le estoy diciendo, I want to activate my service, ¿qué palabra sobresale ahí? La misma pregunta les hago a ustedes. I want to activate my service. ¿Qué palabras sobresalen?
Activate my service.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Dimas. Exactly. Y as, entonces, ok, activate. Si escuchó la palabra activate, muy bien. Entonces, entre la rutina de activar el celular o la tarjeta SIM y pídale el número de SIM. ¿Verdad? Otro ejemplo, por ejemplo. Hey, I don't know what's going on, but why is my bill so high this month? Hey, I don't know what's going on, but why is my bill so high this month? ¿Cuáles son las palabras claves? Keyword.
I don't know.
Okay, sí, va, no sé. Very good.
Repeat, please, Emerson.
Sure. I don't know what's going on, but why is my bill so high this month? La última parte. Why is my bill so high this month?
I don't know. Mm-hmm. What's going? Sería otra.
Okay.
In my bills.
Okay. That's right. Thank you, Dima. Bill. Bill. ¿Qué es bill? Factura. Entonces, ¿qué quiere el cliente? No sabe factura. Doesn't know bill. Ah, got it. ¿Cuál es la idea principal entonces?
Aclararle el tema de la factura, sí.
That's claro. Correct. That's right. Y ese es, thank you, Dimas. Y ese es un coaching de la vida real, jóvenes, para los que ustedes pretendan trabajar en call center. Eso es lo que ustedes van a eso se van a enfrentar ustedes. Eso, para eso tienen que ir ya preparándose. Listening, 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 listening. So, comiencen ahorita. Paren de ver esas sus series y novelas en español y búsquenlas en inglés. Por favor, hagan eso, háganse un favor. Do that, please. Vean las noticias en inglés. ¿Cuánta gente ve noticias en inglés? Ahorita puede ver el coronavirus. Desde YouTube puede ver el BBC, noticias en Inglaterra, Canadá. Y va a ir practicando su listening, ¿ok? Got it?
Más, Dimas, mira la autora Polo.
Ah, cállate. Es bolsa.
Dimas ve Doctor House. Ok, good. Bueno, pues terminemos ya la clase. Vamos a terminar con la lista de vocabulario de hoy, ¿ok? Let's finish with the vocabulary list. Teníamos que agregar más palabras. Se nos vinieron nuevas palabras aquí. Let's see. Let's go to the vocabulary list.
Excuse me, teacher.
Yes.
What's the meaning of forecast?
That's correct. I was about to add that, Dimas. Vamos a agregar aquí a la lista.
Okay.
Forecast es el pronóstico.
Ah.
Forecast. Pero lo vamos a usar con weather forecast. Es el pronóstico del tiempo.
Sí.
Pronóstico del tiempo. Ok. El pronóstico del tiempo. Ok, weather forecast, el pronóstico del tiempo. También íbamos a agregar ahí la palabra consejo. ¿Cómo se dice consejo?
Advice.
Advice. Consejo. A ver, digámoslo, jóvenes. Advice.
Advice.
Y hay un diptongo. Ad es la primera sílaba. Vai.
Vai.
Advice.
Advice.
That's correct. Advice. Y advice no tiene plural. Eso es una observación. En español tiene plural. Nosotros decimos, escucha mis consejos. In Spanish, in English, no puedo decir, listen to my advices. No, just listen to my advice. Hablábamos con Jason esta mañana de uncountables. ¿Verdad, Jason?
Yeah.
Entonces, advice is an uncountable noun. No se puede contar así en inglés. It's uncountable. Es una idea abstracta. Okay? Entonces, por favor, yeah. La idea de advices, no, that's not right. And finally, era, it's a good idea to wear, ¿cómo se decía? ¿Ropa caliente?
Warm clothes.
Y fresca, fresh clothes.
Fresh clothes.
Bueno, ahí está su lista de vocabulario. That's it. Eso es todo. Y tarea para mañana, homework for tomorrow is write an example sentence with the vocabulary. Write an example sentence with the vocabulary. Y esa es su tarea, ¿ok?
Ok.
Ok.
Very good. Terminamos pues con los takeaways. Takeaways para hoy. Takeaways. Van a comenzar y decirme, I'm taking away.
Ok.
Y lo que aprendieron. Ok. Lorena, begin.
Ok. I'm taking away vocabulary. Temperatures, okay. Thermometer, Celsius, and Fahrenheit.
Very good. Thank you. Let's see, Dimas, what are you taking away?
I'm taking away the phrase in any place. It's good idea to wear fresh or...
Oh, it's a good idea.
Yes, it's a good idea to wear warm or fresh clothes.
Good. Thank you very much, Dimas. Jason, what is your takeaway?
Okay. I take away is the vocabulary, is the listening, is the temperature, yeah, is the
Okay, great. I think that's good. Thank you. Thanks. Sí. That's great, Case. Thank you. Good takeaways. Marcos, Mr. Okay. Marcos, estás ahí. Are you there?
I take him away. Water for is Celsius is
se te ve entrecortado. Ok.
Entrecortado.
Sí, se te ve entrecortado o habla más claro. What are you taking away?
I'm taking away weather forecast.
Ah, very good. I'm taking away weather forecast. Thank you, sir. Ahora sí te escuché. Thank you, sir. Good job. Okay. Good job. Jocelyn, what are you taking away?
I'm taking away the temperature with his degrees and his Celsius.
Okay, cambia el pronombre. It's.
Okay. I'm taking away the temperature.
Okay. In degrees.
Yes.
All right. Awesome. Bien, ¿qué me falta aquí? Kenia está por ahí todavía, Kenia. Sí. Ya se derritió. También a distancia se derrite.
Debajo de la cama estoy.
No te veo, acércate más a la cámara. Ahí está, ve. Qué belleza. Miren esos dos esposos aprendiendo inglés. En Semana Santa. ¿Qué les tocó estar aquí, no en el puerto ustedes? Un aplauso para esta pareja hermosa. Come on. Chilero, qué chilero. Good job. A ver, pues.
Good job.
Good job.
I'm taking away the vocabulary.
Very good, Kenya. Muy bien. Ok, guys, entonces eso es todo por hoy. Thank you very much. Les voy a poner la agenda en este momento. Los espero mañana. 3 o'clock, please. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye. Okay. Goodbye, thank you, guys.
Bye.
Be safe.
Goodbye.
Bye. Bye. Bye, teacher. Bye.